Well, as you know by now, Republican Mitt Romney carried Missouri in Tuesday's election. He was a 10-point winner.
But something strange happened. Commitment 2012 coverage continues tonight with Michael Mahoney. What was it, Michael?
Strange indeed, Laura. When a candidate at the top of a ticket wins by 10, like Mitt Romney did here in Missouri, the rest of the party ticket is supposed to benefit. But look at this. Claire McCaskill, 14-point winner on the top for the Democrats. Jay Nixon, Democrat, up by 12. Peter Kinder, Republican Lieutenant Governor, he wins by 5. But again, Democrat Jason Kander, Secretary of State, elected by 1 point. Clint Zweifel, Treasurer, Democrat, elected again by 4 points. Chris Koster, the Attorney General, 17-point Democratic winner. So what happened to Mitt Romney's coattails?
We're going to be studying that for a while, I will tell you that. Mitt Romney's victory last night in Missouri was lonely.
And Democrat Claire McCaskill's 14-point win may be a big part of that. McCaskill spent $6 million getting out the vote and encouraging Missourians to split their tickets. And right behind her on the ballot was the moderate Democratic incumbent, Jay Nixon, another ticket-splitting opportunity for some Republicans. So by the time voters got further down their ballot as they were voting, there wasn't much of a Romney wave left.
The wave hit the first rock and dissipated, and that rock was Claire McCaskill. I mean, one out of every five people that voted for Mitt Romney voted for Claire McCaskill. A stunning development.
Now, McCaskill picked off Republican stronghold counties around here, like Platt and Cass. Another stronghold, Greene County, that's Springfield. And another big GOP strength, St. Charles County, near St. Louis. No coattails for Mitt Romney. Missouri Republicans paid for it. That's the latest from here. Back to you.
All right, Michael, and this makes Missouri all the more interesting because this kind of ticket splitting is leading some political experts like Roe, who you just heard from, to think Missouri may be a presidential battleground state again in 2016.